I've been singing this song all day. Come to town. Oh, yeah. I think he's singing about you, Riley.
I'm pretty sure he is.
PBT producer.
I guess so.
I do know. Y le doy todo el cheque.
Oh my gosh.
Hasta le pongo casa. You can't, you like us raza, we can't compliment anybody, right? I mean, no. You're on social media or Facebook and you compliment somebody, hey, shout out, se sacó la da, quien sabe qué, and then right away they comment, mámalo.
Ponle casa.
Ponle casa, déjale cuero.
That's terrible, right? No.
The
infamous crab effect.
Yeah. Oh my God. Yeah. Hombre, raza.
Big time.
You know how they are. Oh, Raymond Rose says he is absolutely singing about Riley.
You see? He even knows.
Wait till you see her curls today, guys.
Aww.
Yeah. She's so fresh. Ladies and gentlemen, hashtag PVT producer, Riley.
Ooh. Hello, everyone. Hey. So these are my curls. These are my curls.
I love them.
Thank you so much. I do want to send a shout out to everyone on the hashtag PBT chat zone. You all are awesome. I love how everyone just communicates with everyone and says hi to everyone. You guys are so awesome. I really love seeing that. And we love that you guys are here to join us today, tonight. It's a beautiful Saturday. So thank you guys.
You look absolutely stunning.
Oh, thank you.
And I am sure that everybody watching and on the chat zone or in the hashtag PBT chat zone will agree with me and concur. Yeah, I want to thank, I got the barbacoa shirt on.
I know.
Shout out to the law office of Carlos A. Garcia. He is our exclusive sponsor for Tuesday, Tetera Tuesday, and then Throwback Thursday. So, nos mandó unas shirts, because, you know, we wear shirts and stuff like that. So, nos mandó esta shirt, dije, me la voy a poner ahora. Because anyway, tomorrow morning, you know where we're going, right?
To go get barbacoa.
Exactly. Some big red and unas corn tortillas. And not the corn tortillas that are in the freezer. You have to go to the ice chest, right? The
las
ice,
que están recién hechas.
Yeah, they're in the ice chest. And you open them and they're like all covered with a towel. And then you just move the towel and then you pick up a damp little pack of homemade tortillas, right?
Yes.
Or those little corn tortillas. And then you get some salsita. And then you pick up a little, you know, this is at La Michoacana, right? You pick up a little aguacate, right?
Yes.
And then you get some rufles, right? You can't forget the rufles. And then you might get a little bit of cilantro también, right? And you come on home. And unos taquitos de barbacoa en la mañana, papa. Unos scrambled eggs también, porque pues chinga, no, no, you don't want the eggs to get jealous tampoco. ¿Entiendes la una? And asústame one time. El señor Rudo dice que he loves making barbacoa in the slow cooker. Oye,
yes.
¿Es cocinero el Rudo?
That's hardcore.
Con razón lo quieren. Ya sea.
No, he's a keeper.
Y lengua, Rudo, lengua también en la slow cooker. Yeah.
Carmen Benavides, of course she's making menudo.
Yeah.
She's always chatting that she's making amazing things. And it's so true because she sends us pictures of everything. Uh-huh. And I'm like, oh, Carmen. So I totally believe she's making menudo. And so, Carmen, You're awesome.
Le tiene el viejo bien chiflado en la casa.
Big time. Her whole family is blessed to have her.
And not everybody makes the same type of menudo, you know?
Yeah, I mean, the ingredients are for sure different.
I hate it when I go and I buy some menudo or something, and there's a lot of hominy in it. I mean, that's all there is, just hominy and juice, you know? ¿Unta la panza? ¿Unta la carne? I like it when it's real meaty.
But you see, some people like it the other way around.
Like caldo or what?
No, like with more hominy than the little carnitas.
I mean, no, I mean, mine has to have, there's a secret to mm-hmm. having just the appropriate meat in there mm-hmm. and the appropriate and the hominy.
And the appropriate size as well. Yeah. Right? Because yeah. the size can't be like too big and, you know, like it has to be yeah. nicely cut pieces.
And the menudo powder, también, you can't overdo it on that stuff. And you can't mm-hmm. underdo it. You don't want it to taste like water. You know what I mean? So there's some people mm-hmm. have the perfect hand for that stuff. And some people, pues, they're still struggling. ¿Entiendes la onda? Mm-hmm. Pero como quiera, cuando tienes hambre en la mañana, un pinche menudo mientras tenga hominy o lo que sea, ponle agua anything de canal, goes. Carnal.
Anything goes. Anything goes.
Hasta el menudo que prueba agua de canal, carnal. Me lo como. No hay pedo.
Just mix it with a little bit of lime and yeah. it'll be okay.
Con patitas de marrano, dice Mario mm. Flores. I've never, you know what, ladies and gentlemen, I hate to say this, and it might be, you know, sacrilegious or, you know, taboo to say this, pero I've never, ever eaten pig's feet in my menudo. I've never, have you been?
In the menudo, no, but no. I've tried it, uh-huh. and it's okay. It's yeah? pretty good. I mean, just the thought of what it is, it kind of, you know, it's, I'm a little, you know, but I've tried it. It's okay.
Pues es que las hooves son las que están en el soquete todo el día. ¿Entienden la onda? Eso. No sé si se prende mm-hmm. o soquetado, soquetito.
Soquetoso.
Soquetoso. Soquete is a valley word. That's a professional valley word, no?
I think so.
It's lodo, right? It's called lodo. That's the way we're yes. supposed to say it in Spanish. In English, it's mud, and in Spanish, es lodo. But here at Professional Valley Talk, es soquete, carnal. Soquete. Es lo que... Yes.